Welcome to the portion of course where we will learn about many quantum algorithms. We will begin with the Deutsch algorithm. It is relatively simple and somewhat less practical algorithm when compared to Shor's or Grover's algorithms. However, it serves as a good starting point for understanding the basics of quantum algorithms and getting your feet wet. Let's start with the problem definition. Given a function f that takes a single bit as input and yields a single bit output, our goal is to determine whether the function f is constant or balanced. A function is called constant if it produces the same output regardless of the input it receives. In contrast, a function is considered balanced if its yield is zero for half of the possible inputs and one for the other half. Let's consider all the cases for both constant and balanced scenarios. When the function is constant for input 0 and 1, it will either always produce all zeros as output, referred to as case 1, or all 1s as output, case 2. When the function is balanced, we have two additional cases. In one scenario, for input 0 and 1, it will yield the same output of 0 and 1. Case 3. Alternatively, for input 0 and 1, it will yield 1 and 0, which we will call case 4. We will use these cases later in the algorithm. To solve this problem on a classical computer, the function f must be called twice. It is considered constant when both outputs are the same, otherwise it is termed as balanced. The key emphasis here is making two function calls for classical computation. In contrast, in Deutsch algorithm, the function is called only once, as it employs the superposition of all possible inputs. This superposition results in speeding up the quantum algorithm. Now, let's draw the quantum circuit for Deutsch algorithm. It takes inputs ket0 and ket1, and these inputs are processed by Hadamard gates. The results are then passed on to the UF gate, which has been explained in detail in the previous video. Please watch it first in case you have missed it. The UF gate takes input ketx and kety, resulting in output of ketx and ket f of x xor y. Following the application of UF gate, a Hadamard gate is once again applied, but solely to the first qubit. Subsequently, the first qubit is measured. Now, here is the claim. If we measure 0 on the first qubit, the function must be constant. Otherwise, it is balanced. Let's validate this claim. To aid in our verification, we have divided the circuit into four different stages. The first stage is labeled as ket psi 1, the second stage as ket psi 2, the third stage as ket psi 3, and the final stage as catsci 4. Catsci 1 is equal to the tensor product of cat 0 and cat 1, which can also be represented as cat 0 1. To calculate catsci 2, we apply Hadamard gate to the both qubits. Applying a Hadamard gate to cat 0 result in cat 0 plus cat 1 divided by the square root of 2. Similarly, applying a Hadamard gate to cat 1 results in cat 0 minus cat 1 divided by square root of 2. Catsci 2 can be simplified to 1 over 2 times cat 0 0 minus cat 0 1 plus cat 1 0 minus cat 1 1. To calculate catsci 3, we apply UF gate to catsci 2. Remember, UF gate takes cat x and cat y as inputs and yield an output of cat x and cat f of x XOR with y. First, both x and y are equals to 0. Applying UF gate will give us cat 0 and cat f of 0 XOR with 0. The minus sign remains unchanged. Now, when x is cat 0 and y is cat 1, applying UF gate produces cat 0 and cat f of 0 XOR with 1. Next, with x as cat 1 and y as cat 0, applying UF gate results in cat 1 and cat f of 1 XOR with 0. Finally, when x is cat 1 and y is also cat 1, applying UF gate transform it into cat 1 and cat f of 1 XOR with 1. Recall that in case 1, both f0 and f of 1 are equals to 0. Substituting these values for f of 0 and f of 1 simplifies catsci 3 as shown here. Next, we factor out cat 0 from the first two terms and cat 1 from the last two terms. This transforms catsci 3 into cat 0 plus cat 1 divided by square root of 2, cat 0 minus cat 1 divided by the square root of 2. To calculate catsci 4, we need to apply a Hadamard gate to the first qubit. It is important to note that the first qubit is in the state cat plus, which means that applying a Hadamard gate to it will result in cat 0. Now, when we measure the first qubit, we will get cat 0 with 100% probability. In conclusion, when the function is constant in catsci 3, the first qubit will be either cat plus or minus cat plus, and the second qubit will always be cat minus. For those who are unfamiliar, cat plus is represented as cat 0 plus cat 1 divided by the square root of 2, and cat minus is referred as cat 0 minus cat 1 divided by the square root of 2. Applying a Hadamard gate to the first qubit of cat plus will result in cat 0, which will be measured as 0 with 100% probability. Note that we do not have to worry about the potential minus sign with cat 0. Since probabilities are the square of amplitude, it will still be measured as 0 with 100% probability. When the function is balanced in catsci 3, the first qubit will be plus minus cat minus, and the second qubit will be cat minus. In catsci 4, applying Hadamard gate to the first qubit transforms it into get1. Therefore, when the function is balanced, we measure 1 with 100% probability. That's it. It is a straightforward concept. But I strongly advise you to grab a pen and paper and work through the mathematics yourself. Becoming an expert in this field requires hand-on practice. That concludes this video. See you next time.